was inside me. They recognize you. Please don't deny me.
Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Anya. All my new viewers, welcome. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about the experience that I had when I went to Isabella Stewart Museum in Boston. That was my very first time there. I had a wonderful time, but a few things I think everyone should be aware. Since it's still COVID-19 and they don't allow anyone in the building without a face cover. But they allow you to remove your face cover if you're taking a picture. They're not making a big deal about that. As long as you're standing next to someone that's not a part of your party, it's okay. You can remove the mask and then after you're done taking your picture and you can put it back on. Ladies, please don't make the same mistake that I made. You must wear comfortable shoes if you plan on going there. And also, it's very, very hot in there. The face mask was really not helping. I was like so annoyed of how hot I was. I was sweating. My face feels sticky. You know, when you have makeup on and you're sweating, it's not a good thing. So inside the museum, they have a lot of European and Asian and American art and sculptures. Even the wallpaper inside the building is absolutely beautiful. The garden itself is breathtaking. Love the garden. Come on, what's not to like? I think everyone can agree that's a nice area to just sit and relax and not thinking about anything. Make sure your phone face down as well. No Instagram, no Facebook. Just relax, breathe a little bit, you know? Just enjoy the view. And also, they have a lot of decorative art in there. Very, very beautiful, old century look. Like, very cute. But I would not want them in my house. No other museum is quite like this one, with its history, has a private house. So just be prepared to spend more time than you expected. You will come across some empty frame that's in the museum. They all represent those art that was stolen 30 years ago around March. I believe it was March 18. So that being said, if you're looking for an activities to do with your families, this is a great spot to bring them, and the kids will find something new to learn. There's so much to learn in there. There's so much to see in there, and you're all gonna have so many questions. This place is absolutely beautiful, breathtaking, and I think everyone will enjoy it. If you have questions, there's staff in the building that will answer those questions, that will be filling those blank spots for you guys. There's also a cafe in the building that if you get hungry, the kids get hungry, you could just take a break and grab a bite. And also, before you leave, you could stop in the gift shop and grab a souvenir. I highly, highly recommend this place for a first date activities, especially nowadays everyone's doing online dating. And if you're meeting that person for the first time ever, I think you should be in an environment where you surround yourself around other people, where you feel more safe and more calm and just enjoy the moment with that person. So, and also there's gonna be different things that you'll be more focused on instead of like the awkwardness. You know, ladies, I know some of us, like especially with me, anytime I have to go on a first date, I'm always extremely, extremely nervous. My hands start sweating. So just the fact that I know that could happen to me, I feel like if I was there with someone for the first time that I met the person, there was going to be less tension, less awkwardness around us. And I would just have my 100% focus. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm not going to ignore the person. But it's just going to help so much if you in that museum, there's things to do. You know, just enjoy the views together. Hey, look at me. I look amazing, but I also gained so much weight
and I think all of them still look good on me. Hey, look at me. Look at that bald head. Being so extra. Look at me feeling my bald head. I'm a little bit extra, you guys. Extra to the max. So, for all my vloggers, you cannot use your selfie stick in there. You will get in trouble. I found out that as I was using mine, so the main approach was like, you cannot use your selfie stick. I'm like, what do you mean? Other people's doing it. That's why I was doing it. You see, that's the moment. Oh my gosh, look at my boobies in that top. They look so great. So don't do what I did. Do not use your selfie stick. Try your best to use your, just hold your hand. I know sometimes it make the video look shaky, but try your best. And if you're gonna do it, just hide it. Don't let people see that you're doing it. That's all I can say. As every other museum, you're not allowed to touch anything. You're not allowed to use the flash in your phone when you're taking the pictures. So it's just like very, very simple rules. But they all, every other museum have those little simple rules. You cannot touch anything. Just stay still, look, don't touch. Just like we'll be saying, ladies, you can look, but you cannot touch us at all. No touching. Overall, I had a wonderful time when I went there. It was such a great day to be there. It was not crowded at all. So I will definitely go back there again. And I highly recommend it to anyone that wanna go there. And especially if you new in town, you just want to find something to do, this is a spot for you. And you're gonna have a good time. Thank you so much, you guys, for watching. Don't forget to comment, subscribe, like. See you guys soon. Much love. Mwah.